Yes, we can begin.
I'm called Dr. Kalist Tindimugaya. Mm-hmm. I'm an ambassador on UPGro. Yeah. I also represent the African continent on the International Association of Hydrogeologists Councils. I'm the vice president in charge of Sub-Saharan Africa. But in Uganda, I work for the Ministry of Water and Environment. I head the Department for Water Resources Planning and Regulation, mm-hmm. where groundwater is also included. Mm-hmm.
So how important is groundwater to adaptation to climate change, especially for the African continent?
First of all, one needs to appreciate that groundwater is actually being used to meet various needs of the people. In most of Africa, drinking water is actually got from underground water. When you see boreholes, you see springs, you see gravity flow scheme, shallow wells constructed, that is underground water. Actually, most of the people, especially in rural areas, depend on underground water. Mm-hmm. In urban areas right now, groundwater is actually being used because many of the surface water sources are drying up. Again, we are seeing groundwater being used also to supplement irrigation. People right now cannot grow crops all year round just because the water is limited. So right now we are seeing actual groundwater being very, very important as a way of dealing with water scarcity. Climate change, of course, comes with challenges. Too little water. Many rivers, lakes are drying up and people are resorting to water that is underground.
So being that important, is this resource really being captured in the climate negotiations?
Not at all. Well, maybe just to mention that in the climate negotiations, actually, issues of water were never given attention. It's just recently that water issues started coming on the fore, and by implication, of course, groundwater was not being used, discussed. But also groundwater has always been forgotten, even the broad water discussion. So you can imagine, the negotiations were not dealing with the water. By implication, groundwater was not being given much attention. But I'm happy to note that in COP25, water issues are becoming really very prominent, and groundwater issues are also starting to feature. And I think we can pick from here moving forward.
So what do we need to do to build the capacities of the negotiators to have the groundwater question into the negotiation rooms?
First of all, groundwater is undercover. It's not seen and oftentimes forgotten. And many of the people who deal with the negotiations are looking at things that are happening on the surface. They see flood water, that's what attracts attention, but they don't see what is happening underground. So what we need to do right now, first of all, is to bring information on groundwater to their attention. How much water, for example, do underground water do we have? And how is it changing over time? I think this information has remained probably with us as groundwater specialists. We now need to demystify groundwater, mm-hmm. bring groundwater from underground and bring it to the surface, mm-hmm. and try to communicate it also in the language that people understand. Mm-hmm. I think we have also tended to communicate it in the technical jargon, and people don't understand. So to me, I think we don't have a lot of groundwater information all over the continent, but what we have can actually also be brought to the attention of the negotiators so that they know that this water is not found everywhere, but it's a resource that is resilient to climate change, that in situations of water scarcity, actually groundwater is there to save lives.
Now, can you talk about this call to action petition that is being signed around the world? What is the importance of this?
Well, the call to action is actually basically trying to get the world to realize that you can no longer take groundwater for granted. This groundwater can actually get finished. So we are trying to make sure that the world gets to know that this is a resource that we are depending on, and in many areas it is actually being depleted. So we want to make sure that it is developed in a sustainable manner. In some areas it is being polluted. In the other areas it's actually being wasted. So the call to action is really calling upon the whole world to recognize that there is a resource that is very, very important, that is saving and supporting livelihoods, that can actually help us to adapt impacts of climate change, but this resource has to be managed in an integrated manner for the benefit of the present and future generation, but we also need to invest in understanding this resource. In many parts of Africa, the people drill wells, but they don't know where they are getting the water. They don't know even how much is there. They don't even know how much they are getting out. Often times people think there is a lake underground, mm-hmm. and they are just pumping. Mm-hmm. So until the wells dry up, that they realize that actually there is no water. So the call to action is basically getting all of us to recognize the importance of this resource, but also recognizing that this resource has to be developed and managed in a sustainable manner.
So how is this message going to get to the policymakers?
As of now, the call to action has gone out, has been signed by over 700 professional scientists. It is now being disseminated widely, but also we want to pick it up next year. For example, the theme for the World Water Day is water and climate. We want to take advantage of that. Next year, we are also considering having an international groundwater summit so that we can get people to discuss groundwater issues. Also want to make sure that groundwater is taken up at various levels all over the world so that this message can reach everybody. Mm-hmm. So we are basically calling upon everybody, all those people who deal with groundwater at the national level, at regional level, at the basin level, international level, to disseminate this information and use every opportunity to pass over this information. Of course, people like you, the media, also would want to appeal to you to capture this information and maybe help us communicate in the language people understand. Mm-hmm. I think as groundwater professionals, we are not good at communicating. Mm-hmm. So we would want to get people like you to help us get out the messages in the language people understand.
Okay. So do you think Africa has adequate policies to address groundwater?
Now, in many countries, you find that they have water policies, but they are silent on groundwater. The focus has always been given on surface water. But we do believe that with the policies, the water policies that are existing, it's just a matter of tweaking those policies to give attention to groundwater. So personally, I don't think that we need to think about completely new policies. It's just to recognize that groundwater and surface water are interrelated. Groundwater feeds streams in the dry season, but also streams feed groundwater in certain periods when the flows are very high. So groundwater and surface water are two sides of the coin. Mm-hmm. If we have water policies, we need to make sure that these policies recognize the water underground and the water on the surface so that we can develop them in a coordinated and sustainable manner. Mm-hmm. We also need to integrate groundwater issues in basin plans. Right now we are developing basin plans. We have transboundary programs, even at the country level, we are developing basin plans. We need to make sure that groundwater is actually captured. We assess available water, considering surface water and groundwater. And through that, then groundwater will actually become prominent and get the recognition that is needed. Uh-huh. But of course, capacity is still limited, uh-huh. so we need to build our capacity at the country level, at the local level, so that we can ensure that groundwater issues are given adequate attention. In many countries also, groundwater monitoring is not being done. A few countries are doing it. My country, Uganda, for example, we are doing groundwater monitoring, but I know not many countries in Africa actually monitoring. And the moment you don't monitor, then it becomes difficult to manage. You can't manage. You can't develop what you don't know. So groundwater monitoring is very important. Groundwater assessment is equally important. So again, we want to get this movement so that groundwater issues are given as much attention as surface water. Mm-hmm.
So what kind of outcome do you expect from the negotiations in Madrid in relation to groundwater and water in general?
First of all, as I mentioned, groundwater issues have lagged behind. So we are now in Madrid trying to make sure that water issues are given attention. We have had this, a number of sessions I've been involved in, where we are trying to advocate for considering adaptation through improved water management. So we are saying that for you to adapt to impacts of climate change, you need to improve the way you manage the water. Now, once you improve the way you manage the water by implication, then you manage groundwater. So right now, I think what is coming out strongly is the recognition that we can no longer take water for granted. In the many discussions already, it has been recognized that integrated water resources management is key. We're also talking about nature-based solutions to actually adapting to impacts of climate change, that you need to look at nature so that it helps you to deal with climate change. And of course, when we talk about nature, we're talking about restoring wetlands. Mm-hmm. We're talking about improving the tree cover. We're talking about restoring the river banks. And then for us, the moment you improve the natural sources base, you restore those degraded ecosystems, then our groundwater recharge will improve, and then groundwater will contribute much more strongly. So the message that is coming out strongly here is water issues need to be given more attention, and I think groundwater should ride on that, mm-hmm. so that when we come to the next COP, mm-hmm. then groundwater becomes a thematic area for discussion.
Okay, thank you very much.
Welcome.